Benjamin, he got Benjamins.
Fast car, I want all the smoke. Yeah, 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 all the smoke. Porsche 911 can't see me no more. I be a papa, I want some more.
Got my master account right there, and I also have that secondary account that's going to be copied to this account as well. So I have both my master and then my secondary. We're just going to do a little quick test to see if it actually works. So we're going to go ahead and get in a trade, right? Seven. And what I'm going to do is we're going to see if it actually copies it, all right? And we're going to see how fast it'll take to copy on this account. So we're going to go ahead and test in 3, 2, 1. So as you could see, the price 1827.47 at 0.01 was placed here. And as soon as I did it, it automatically placed it here as well. Welcome, welcome everyone. Here is a closer look. I'm now on the call and I have a special guest with me. His name is Ty. He's a close friend of mine and he actually helped me set up. Is in the process of helping me set up the copier. He, you know, took time out of his day to show you guys how to do it. His YouTube channel is actually Ty Norris, where he's actually taking part of his Forex Fund challenges as well with the copier, something that I want to get into. And you guys can follow him on his social media on there. So Ty, we have you here. You can introduce yourself, tell the people a little bit about yourself and, you know, how long you've been doing automation, and we can go ahead and get this started for this nice video we got here.
All right, my name is Ty Norris. I've been trading robots and doing automation and working with different copiers for about 3 years now. I know pretty much all of the ins and outs of it, not saying like I'm the guru or the expert, you know, but I do know my stuff whenever it comes to things like this. So we about to dive straight into it, and hopefully everybody will be able to proceed in the future.
So what is the first step as far as, okay, I'm new, I know about the Forex, I got my account, I got a trading account right here, but I want to be able to get a copier so I could trade this account and then someone like my mom or my relative could copy what I'm trading. What would be the first step?
Let's walk through. The first step would be to go to forexvps.net. And I'm pretty sure that Zola's going to have a link in the description below. But once you go to forexvps.net, you want to purchase your VPS. And once you receive your VPS information, which will be your IP address, your username, and your password, which you will get in an email, then that would be your login details. So Zola, if you want to, you can go in and click on my accounts if you want to show them in the top right.
I got my VPS here. This is actually a pretty decent VPS, guys. So we got the VPS, my account. So yeah, the VPS plan that I have is the basic plus for $39.99 a month. But they have different options here. Let me see how I could go to the different options. Yeah.
If you want to go to the different options, you can click on order new VPS.
Order new VPS. Okay, here's a different option. So it shows a scale of basic, basic plus, standard, and high frequency. The one I've been using is basic plus, and the one Ty you use is basic plus too? Or do you use a different one?
I use high frequency just because of the amount of accounts that I have copied.
So the amount of accounts you have copied is important because it gives you more RAM, gives you more storage. So mine is basic plus because I don't have that much copied yet on an account that I'm about to get to, just a few accounts that I'm handling, but Ty has a bit more. So he has a high frequency, but yeah, it's good to know that. And that's the packages, and I have my VPS here. So after you order the VPS and they give you the VPS, which I have, what would be now?
All right. If you would like to show them how the email will actually look, you can click on the person icon in the top right by the alert. You can click right there and then you can go to email history. And then this is what the email you should be looking for looks like. So scroll all the way down, probably have to go to the third page. And Well, go to the second page. I'm sorry.
Second page.
And then scroll out, and it'll say it right there. The third one up, New Forest Virtual Server Information. You can click this on one. View message.
This one right or here.
Either or. And you can see right there in the email where it has main IP port. That'll be your BPS number. Your username will be Trader, and then that will be your password.
Yeah, the password. I got you.
All right. So now what we can do is we can go ahead and just log into your VPS.
So for me using Windows, I have a VPS. You guys could find it on the remote. You come here and you search the remote. So I use the remote desktop connection. What would it be for iMac, for users that have iMac?
All right, if you have an iMac like me, you just need to go to the App Store and then just put in remote desktop connection. The app that I use is called RD Client. That's just the best one that I like to, that I prefer. That's the easiest one for me to use.
So let me go ahead and log out here and start over. I was just on a VPS. So here's the remote desktop connection where you put your IP address, your username, and then the password. Since I already have mine and it's connected, you guys will see that you'll be able to log in. Why is it good to have a VPS with a copier, Todd? What's the purpose of a VPS?
Main purpose of a VPS would be so you don't have to have your computer on and running 24 hours, 5 days a week due to the market. Because if you were just running it on your regular PC, once you turn it off, or if it goes in sleep mode, power down, or anything of that nature, that's gonna also turn off the copier. So with you having a VPS, it's staying connected to the internet 24/5.
Gotcha. There you guys have it.
All right, so now the first thing what you wanna do inside the VPS is you wanna go to the internet browser once you get in. So you wanna click on Chrome. All right, and the first thing what you would like to do is, I just recommend everybody to go to hugosway.com. And then once you get on hugosway.com, you wanna click on download MT4, which you already
have. Yeah, I got mine. Yeah.
All right, and then also, now you wanna go and download the files. So go back to Chrome. And the website that you wanna go to is gonna be ea-coder.com. This is just a copy. There's a lot of cheaper copiers out there, but this is like my best one. It's going to be a dash.
Ready?
Yes. Coder.com. All right. So once you get on this website right here, what you want to do is you want to then click on MT4 apps at the top.
Got you.
And once you click on MT4 apps, you want to scroll down and you'll see it right there. Local trade copier MT4. You want to click on that.
Right here?
No, just click on the, you can just click on the picture.
So I got information in here, right?
Well, you want to scroll down first and select which plan.
Okay, yeah. So.
Well, click on get started. I'm sorry.
Get started. Some nice website.
All right, so
VIP plan, personal plan. So manager plan, it looks like it says it simulates 5 times computer VPS and then it simulates as 15. So me not using as much, I'm gonna go with the 60. Is you use the 60 or you use more of the VIP?
Well, because I run on multiple VPSs, I actually use that one right there, the 60. But if you're only planning on using this on one VPS, not running it on multiple VPSs like me, you could get away with just the personal plan, only being able to operate it on one. So, from there, you can be able to decide on which one. But you could always use the manager mode because if you're going to be using like a robot like me, you will need that martingale mode. But if you're not going to be running bots, then you won't need it. Yeah. But you know, it's always best to have the $60 plan. All right, and then from here, you would just check out.
You got any discount coupons? No,
I wish, yeah.
I wish. So, guys, after you go ahead and purchase the copier, you'll come to this page. As you can see, thank you. Your order has been processed and complete. And actually send it to my email. So let me go ahead and go to the email real quick. Right? And they sent you... they will send you a welcome email, which will have your login to the EA website where you can download the files and get your license key. So this is the EA we have here. I went ahead and put the email that I told them to send me the license key in, and I went and generated the password. Let's log in. So boom. So now we're here. Let's go to the download center that they told us to do. And then boom. So this is where we at. Ty, we got the license key right here, as you mentioned. So what would we do next now?
All right, so now you would like to go inside of the VPS again. And inside of the VPS, you just wanna go back to that same license key and you wanna download those files onto the VPS. So you wanna go to the EA Coder, .com, which I believe you may already be on it. Yeah, on that tab right there.
Yeah.
Yep, you can click on local trade copier or log in. You just want to get signed in to the download center. Yeah. Or you can just type in, you can go back to that email and copy and paste the web address too, if that'd be easier for you. Then you want to log in using your email and password.
Go ahead, log in. After we do that, all right. Now we logged in.
All right. And once you're logged in, you want to go up and click on the local trade copier MT4 where it says manager license right there. And once you do that, you want to click on the first one. That's just the most updated version. With the updated version, you can actually copy MT5 to MT4 or MT4 to MT5. All right, so you want to hit the back arrow now. And you want to keep, once you hit the back arrow, you want to make sure that you keep the license key pulled up because you're going to need to put it inside of the software. So you want to hit the back arrow just so you have your license key pulled up.
All right, so show in folder?
No, you don't have to do that just yet. All right, so just go back and hit the back arrow or click on downloads so that way we can get to the license key. All right, so now you see the downloads folder that you already have opened at the bottom?
Yeah.
All right, so you wanna go to your downloads folder? All right, and since you're gonna be using Prosperity, or we can use Hugo's way, it doesn't really matter. What you wanna do is double click on one of the brokers that you'll be using. Either Hugo's way or Prosperity, it doesn't matter because inside of the MT4, you can type in any broker of your choice.
Yeah, I'm gonna get Hugo's way.
No, you have to do it differently.
Okay.
Yeah, you can't click on it that way. You got to set up the terminal.
So exit out. Exit this out. So go to hugosway.com.
No, no, no. You want to go to the downloads folder. And then you see where it say Hugo's Way setup right there?
Yeah, right here.
You want to double click on that? All right. And then you want to hit run. And then let's see. Click on settings. Don't hit next. And you want to hit browse. And then this is where I like to mainly set up my main terminal first. So what you want to do is you want to click on local disk C, where it says local disk C. All right. And then you want to click on program files 86, which is right below that. And then you want to click on make new folder at the bottom. All right, and you can name this main account, master account, or you can name it, you know, Zoe's account, whoever is going to be the master account. Just so that way you want to just be able to identify which folder it is, just in case in the future you ever have to change it.
Right, right.
All right, so then now you can hit OK. And then hit next. All right, and then now this one's gonna be downloading. And then after that, we'll go through and make the, go through and do the same exact process. It's just we're gonna name the folders whoever your clients will be or whoever you're gonna be copying into.
Okay.
And then from there, that's whenever we install the copier and then it'll be done. All right, and hit finish.
Finish. So we got the Hugo's Way pulled up now, and what I'm going to do is do what Ty recommended to do. We're going to look for the broker's name for the account I want as a master copier, and we're going to log into that account. So what I'm doing is, once you get your account, guys, you want to look for the settings on MT4 and look at the top, and you'll see what the broker name is. So right now, that's what I'm doing here. I'm just going to scan it to see if they can search it for me.
Yeah, just type in Traders Glow. Just put in Traders Glow, GLO, and then hit enter, and then it normally pops up for me. Just one word. Oh, well, it worked.
All right, Traders Glow. Alrighty. All so right. Now, as you can see, guys, it pulled up. We're logged in. So now, let me exit these out so it doesn't make it that slow. Just keep on. Now we'll just leave it on Euro USD. Okay.
All right. So now you want to go back to the downloads folder?
Sir.
And then you want to click on Hugo's Way setup again. Mm-hmm. Click on run. Click settings. Mm-hmm. And then you want to click on browse. And then you want to go to local disk C again. Click on program file 86.
Yeah.
And then once you click on program files 86, you want to click on make new folder. And then this is where you would like to name it, name your clients or whoever you'll be copying for.
Gotcha.
Just so you can identify which folder is for which person.
All right.
Hit OK. Yeah. And then hit next.
So yeah, guys, usually you want to make sure you have good internet connection. You don't want to have multiple devices like an Xbox on or a PlayStation. You want to make sure that you guys could have good internet connection, because sometimes it could take a little bit slow. We're going to hit finish. But usually when you have a good VPS, like the one we showed you earlier, it could help with your internet be a little bit more faster. So now we just wait, and we'll wait until it comes on. So that was actually pretty quick, guys. As you can see, we got the other MT4 popped up. So we're going to do the same thing. Traders Glow. And then we're going to look for the account again. And then I'm going to go ahead and get that for you guys as well. So, guys, I'm just doing the same thing I did last time. Just logging in. And we just wait as we log in. Takes a couple seconds, guys.
All right. And while we're waiting on this right here to log in, if you want, we can go ahead and go to the download folder and start extracting those files. All right, so you want to right click on that zip folder?
Okay, nice, we're logged in. Right click on the zip.
Then you want to click extract all.
Extract all.
Mm-hmm. All right, and then once you hit extract all, you want to just click extract.
This one, have this checked too when it's saying it. Show extracted files when complete.
Well, you can uncheck that because we're already at the download file folder anyway.
Okay, so extract.
All right, so then you see now the top folder, LTC Manager.
Right here. Right click or just click it normally?
Yeah, just click it normally. You want to open that folder up. All right, guys, and right here is where you would want to make sure and pay attention that you're doing the right, you're installing the right files onto the right terminal. So you see how the first one says client and then the second one says server? Well, the first set. Because if you have MT4, that's the files for MT4. If you're using an MT5, those are the files for MT5.
So we're using MT4. So this is for client MT4. Yeah. And then that's client MT5. And then that's server MT4 and server MT5. So I see what you're saying. You want to make sure you get the right one.
Yeah. So client goes to client and server goes to the master account. So what you want to do is you want to just double click on MT4 manager server. So that one right there, you want to
double right click or double click?
Just double click. Double click. Open it up. Okay. All right. Then you want to hit run. All right. And then once you hit run, you want to hit I accept the agreement. All right. Then you want to hit next. Hit next again. All right, and then right here, this is why I told you to name the files, name the folders, so that way you'll be able to identify them. So the master, you want to go up and click that box for master.
This one, my bad.
Yes. Gotcha. And then once you click that, you want to hit next.
Wait, do I have to have it on the account? Because I'm logged in into the...
It's fine. It's going to sync up. Yeah, it's okay.
Okay.
Yeah, so you just want to go back to that. Yeah, hit next. Master copy. Then it's going to install it. Hit next again. All right, then hit finish. All right, and then now you want to go back to the LTC manager folder at the bottom. And then this time we're going to do MT4 client.
Double click.
Yep. And then you're going to hit run. And then after you hit run, you're going to hit I accept, then hit next. And then same exact thing, you're going to check the clients that you're going to be using. Hit next. And then you're going to hit next again.
and then finish.
Yeah, and then hit finish.
All right, so I think it's finished now.
Yes, correct. All right, so what you wanna do is you can go ahead and exit out of this folder now because we're completely done with that. Everything from here will be done inside of the terminals.
Gotcha.
All right, so what you wanna do is you see the section over there where it shows you like expert advisor, script, your account information. You wanna just drag that over a little bit so you can see very clearly. You know, the name of the folders and stuff.
Like this?
Yeah. So what I like to do is from the beginning, I like to go ahead and turn auto trading on. So you want to go ahead and turn auto trading on. Then you want to go down to expert advisors. And then you're going to right click on it first and hit refresh. This right here will make the files that we just installed appear. So okay. Once you click on refresh and then you hit the plus symbol beside expert advisors. And then now you should see server. So then what you would do is you would drag and drop that onto the chart.
Which time frame you does it matter? The time frame?
It doesn't matter because it doesn't matter which time frame or chart that you on because this is just making the this is just turning on the copier. So it's basically it's gonna copy whatever you take, whatever trades you take on the master account. So it doesn't matter.
Drag it and then
drop.
Drop.
All right. So first things first, you want to go to the comment tab at the top.
Gotcha.
You want to hit allow DLL imports. All right. And then you want to go to inputs. All right. And then right there where it says license key, that first box.
Right here.
Yeah. You want to double click inside of that box. And then you want to go back and get your license key from the purchase.
It's just loading up. Give it some time. So as you guys can see, it finally loaded up. Let me go and copy that license key. So we're gonna go back here after we copied the license key and we put it in here, right?
Yes, correct. All right, and then from here, you would just hit okay. Press okay again. All right, and then now what you wanna do is you see how in the top right, how it says master account.
Sure.
This is how you know it's copied, it's set up for your master account. So then now you want to go to your secondary account. Same thing, you want to move it over so you can see it clear and, you know, close out some of those extra charts. All right, and then you want to turn on auto trading, hit refresh on the expert advisors.
Client, right?
Yes, correct. You want to drag and drop that on the chart. And with this one is a little bit different. You still want to go to your comment tab.
Okay.
And then hit allow DDL imports. And then in inputs, you want to go over the inputs now. I changed different things in here. So let's say that you wanted to copy the exact same lot size, right?
That's what you were saying earlier. Right.
Yeah. So if you scroll down a little bit, you see where it says money management mode? Well, go back up a little bit. It's like the second column right there.
Yeah.
You see how it says AA auto adjust account sizes?
Yeah.
All right. So that's going to basically auto adjust it. So if you have a 100K account and you run a 1.0 and then somebody has a 20K account, it's going to automatically adjust that lot size to make it the same exact risk as the 100K to a 20K. So basically they were divided by five because, you know, it's, you know, that's 1/5 of 100K.
That makes sense. So for me, like I was telling you, I want to copy the same exact lot size because all the accounts are, again, the same from the challenge. So, and we'll just do a copy lot size. So how would I change it to the same lot size?
All right, so you would double click on the auto adjust.
There's a drop bar you can click.
And then it says same lot size as master account.
Perfect.
All right. And then there's different things as well. Like if you scroll down, you'll see where it says like trade comments. So like
I accidentally stolen the Dropbox.
Okay.
Okay. There you go.
Yeah. So, you know, if you go on down, if you scroll down, it'd be like, it'll say trade manipulations. That's the name of it. But besides that, everything else is like slippage. You can play with these settings, guys, and find out exactly what you're looking for. But the main ones that I do is the lot size mode. And then I look for trade manipulations.
Trade manipulations. Trade comment.
Yeah. Yeah. So right there. Oh, hold on. Go up. You passed it. Go up a little bit more. Where you seeing trade comments at? Because that was right there. Yeah. Scroll up a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So right there. Right here, you see how you have reverse trading. So that means that if the master account places the buy, it'll place the sell on the other ones. So that's why you want to make sure that that's false, unless that is a service that you want. How it says it copy exact trade comments. So like, let's say that you're using a robot and you don't want the comments to show up on your client's account because you don't want them to know what robot you're using, or maybe you don't even want them to know you're using a robot. If you change that from true to false, it won't copy trade comments. So, but you don't have to worry about that because you're not using the bot. So from here, you can just press okay.
All right. And then, so usually as you place a lot size, since this is exactly the same, when I enter a trade and close a trade, it'll do the same on the other account as well.
Yes, correct.
Nice. All right. So I think that's everything here, right? We have the master account and now it says my client account. Go back and see here. We have my master account. So now, guys, I have a master account. And in this video, we only connected two accounts, for one account to the other master. And I'm going to show you guys how it looks when I place a trade and you could see it copied to another account, right? On my other phone. And I'll see you guys in the next segment of the video. Todd, is there anything you'd like to say before we end it off?
If you have any questions or would like to follow me, my YouTube is I Am Ty Norris, and I'm also on Instagram at I Am Ty Norris as well. So if you have any questions or any concerns, you can always reach out to me.
Perfect. Let's go ahead and run it up, Ty, and let's get this money, man. Thank you, and appreciate everything you did in this video. This was a well-explained video. Again, we're just showcasing you guys what's out there and how to help, and we'll see you in the next segment of the video. Thank you, guys.
And thank you for introducing me into your platform.
Yeah.
So guys, here's the next segment of the video where I went ahead and had both accounts here. Got my master account right there. And I also have that secondary account that's going to be copied to this account as well. So I have both my master and then my secondary. We're just gonna do a little quick test to see if it actually works. So we're gonna go ahead and get in a trade, right? Do a buy limit 127. Let's see if I could do a buy limit here 127.47. And what I'm going to do is we're going to see if it actually copies it, all right? And we're going to see how fast it'll take to copy on this account. So as soon as I place a trade on this, we're going to, it should copy here. So we're going to go ahead and test in 3, 2, 1. So as you can see, the price 1827.47 at 0.01 was placed here. And as soon as I did it, it automatically placed it here as well. 1827.47, 0.01 lot size. So what I'm going to do is now I'm going to delete it. And we'll see it deleted there. First here, then there, as you've seen. So that was deleted. And again, guys, I did some practice runs on this account. It's in the history, as you can see here. Those same buy limits is going to be in the history as well, as you can see there. And this is the test. And again, guys, this is my live account, right? This is a live account, Forex Funds live account. And as you can see on this account, it was profited, but I took the buy limits for the purpose of this video to copy on the other account. Okay, so that's about it for this video, guys. Thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next segment of the video. So guys, as you can see, we're gonna end it off in this video. And really the purpose of this video was to show you guys how to really copy a trading account to someone else's account automatically using a trade copier. I had that special guest on here to be able to showcase you guys how to do that. It's an easy step, guys. Once you're able to do that, you can capitalize on copying one phone to another phone, one account to another account. So you don't have to be in the habit of, let me trade on this phone. That is something I did not like doing. Again, these are new tools, resources, and what we're wanting to give you all as becoming traders with us at fxcapitalonline.co. Right? Time's changing, guys. We want things to be more at peace. We want things to be more easier. And these are things that many traders can do with their trading accounts. So again, guys, I want to make sure that you guys like, share, and comment this video. Make sure you do click the links in the descriptions below to get started. And go ahead and write a comment, leave us a review on how we did in this video. And if you need any more questions or concerns about this video, right, if you have any more questions or concerns in this video, go ahead and write it in the comment and we'll get back to you. Thank you, guys, and we'll see you guys soon. Happy copying.